Let's take a quick look today at the Diamond SRJ77CA in a female, or known as a reverse SMA. That's a female SMA adapter. Also, for comparison purposes, a SMA male SRH77CA. So if you have a reverse female, it's a SRJ77 male SRH77. So anyways, these antennas rated for 10 watts, 2.15 dB gain, 50 ohms, saddle little specs, made by Diamonds. They are great antennas. I put this one on the TYT THUV88 and it made it into a fire breathing dragon. What's that old CB term? All mouth and no ears? Well, the stock rubber duckies on the Anytone 878s. Those things are nothing more than a radiating dummy load, if you can see this. They say high gain antenna on them. But they're kind of piss poor. They are marginal, excuse my language. They do work. They will work. Not going to get any range. If you're within a repeater zone, underneath a repeater, across the room from a hotspot, they work great. They also work okay for receiving stuff out of band, public service stuff. But anyways, we're going to put this onto there and bring this radio to life. And like back to that old CB term, what is that term, all mouth, no ears? Well, this thing is one hot performing antenna. A little pricey, but well worth it. Very rugged. But I want to show you something when I put this on the antenna, on the radio. The Comet SMA24J, you can see, covers that area. Fits right in there. It's tapered. No dirt, no debris is going to get into there. But let me show you what happens when you put the Diamond SRJ77CA on there. Fits down in there snug, screws in nicely, but you're left with a little divot, a pocket. Dust bunny is going to build up around there. If you bring it outside, a little bit of moisture, condensation, dirt, sand, who knows? You know, I wish they would have done something like the Comet, blended it in, made it taper out, but I guess we don't know what kind of radio it's going to go on. He designed it to fit a little bit of everything. There we go, got the other radio in APRS mode. Looks like it just sent a packet. But anyway, so let's go outside. We'll go to our furthest repeater away that I normally can't key up, which is Gore over New York, which is about 85 air miles away, and we'll see if the Diamond can do the trick. Didn't do it on the TYT THUV88, but Anytone's a little bit better receiver, a little bit better transmitter. While we're at it, I want to point something out. The Comet SMA24J has it tapered up. There's no weight of the antenna on that little micro connector, which is good. This Diamond SRJ77CA, this is a big beefy antenna. There's a lot of stress on that little connector, that SMA, so I got to be careful with this. Okay, and while we're at it, I want to make mention, you know, if this radio tips over, falls, or drop it, all antenna. Antenna's got enough mass where it'll probably support it. But what will it do to the SMA adapter connector in there? Will it tear it out? I don't know. You know, the Comet SMA24J has that little tapered area, thin antenna that's flexible. You bend this thing right over, springs back to shape. You know, so this is the pros and cons of an antenna. Big, heavy, stiff antenna that has some gain, some receive capabilities. One that claims to have some gain. It's flexible. You know, each has its pros and cons. It's all up to you. Everybody's going to want something different. I like Comet, and I like Diamonds. I got burnt to Diamonds in the past, so I steered clear of them, but I guess I'm giving them a second try. Okay, I'm outside here in the shade because it's like 95 degrees and 97% humidity. I can't key up Gore. So went to the truck, went to the ICOM 706 Mark IIG. I can't key up Gore there either, so Gore must be down. So kind of have to think of another plan to show you what we could listen to, maybe. Okay, so I'm on APRS RAW. I can't see the information that's coming across the screen. Maybe we can. Anyways, it just went off. We received something on APRS. Let's see what we received. We received K2, but he came through K1EQX. So yeah, so we're picking up K1EQX out of Mount Equinox here in Rutland City on HT. That is pretty damn impressive. I couldn't do it on the stock rubber ducky. And I hate to say it, but I don't think the Comet SMA24J antenna can receive that either. Not when I've been outside testing like this. So, anyways, it's hot. It's humid. Hate to cut this video short, but maybe we'll go inside, put on some railroads, some Vermont Police, some ambulance and stuff, and see what we listen to. And okay. That's the Colchester Police Department. We just heard their repeater ID.
549 Rutland.
Listen to that.
549.
I live in Rutland City, Vermont. Colchester is at least 60 miles north of me. I don't know where that repeater is, but I never heard it before off the Comet SMA24J. Amazing. Okay, they're both scanning. I hit the one here on the right. The Comet SMA24J before I hit the Diamond SRJ77CA. They've both been scanning, and we've seen in the video where the Diamond picking things up and the Comet antenna is really skipping over a lot of it and only picking up the really strong local stuff. So, makes you wonder. The Diamond really is a little bit better antenna.